We've got lots and lots of videos on the way to keep you company. We're in this together. By practicing social distancing at the moment, you're being responsible by staying in and doing your part in helping the situation out there. Abiding by the World Health Organization and Center for Disease Control guidelines is definitely a good thing. But being stuck inside by yourself without your daily routine can lead to being overwhelmed by worries about your health, family, finances, and the rest of the world, which is bound to take a toll on your mental health. The best thing to do is try to cope effectively. Here are 8 things to remember during the coronavirus pandemic. 1. Move your body. Have you been planning on starting exercise for a while now? It's a great way to release your body's happy pill, the endorphins, to cope with the world's current period of stress. YouTube is filled with workout videos and yoga videos that you can follow along with, and many of them require no equipment. Personal trainers are using Instagram Live to give free classes throughout the day. If you'd rather go at your own pace, Pinterest is filled with exercise lists and diagrams and ideas. 2. Be careful how you use social media. Have you been spending most of your time mindlessly scrolling through your social media apps? Do similar stories about fights over toilet paper or complaints about boredom keep popping up before you in a loop? It's mentally draining to be reminded of such things, so be careful. When you pick up your phone or open your laptop, be mindful of how it's affecting you. Using it as entertainment is definitely fine. And let's face it, it can be fun to see what our friends are up to or laugh at funny or relevant memes. But be aware of how you manage the stress it can bring. 3. Use technology to connect emotionally. Have you been keeping in touch with your loved ones virtually? Being physically distanced doesn't mean we have to be emotionally distanced too. You can still be close to others by talking to them on the phone and sending each other text messages. You can still entertain each other by playing games against each other online. And video calling can keep each other company virtually. Many people are getting creative by creating chat rooms and channels where they can hang out together over the internet while playing the same things or mixing the same drink. Reaching out to others in the same situation as you can do a great deal to boost morale and feel connected. 4. Get dressed every morning. Have you been walking around in your PJs the whole day? Do you feel the novelty of that experience wearing off now? Let's face it, it felt good to laze around in PJs once in a while, but now the monotony is just making you dull. So in addition to simply getting up according to your normal routine, getting dressed normally can also work to improve your mental health. It signals to your brain that it's time to start the day. And according to Jennifer Musselman, putting on an outfit in the morning releases neurotransmitters in our brains, including dopamine, serotonin, norepinephrine, and endorphins, the chemicals in your brain that control your mood, sparking a sense of purpose. The old adage, if you look good, you feel good, rings particularly true in this situation. 5. Nourish your body with healthy food. Have you heard the phrase, you are what you eat? The food you eat tremendously influences your mental health. An article by Dr. Maxine Barish-Redden talks about how an inadequate diet can worsen or even lead to stress and depression. It details how sugar and processed foods are associated with inflammation in the body and brain, and therefore may contribute to issues regarding mood. So when everything else is chaotic and unpredictable, fueling your bodies with what it needs is a great way to help yourself cope better. 6. Practice self-care. Do images of bubble baths and face masks come to your mind when self-care is mentioned? Self-care is simply anything we do that helps us relax, promotes emotional well-being, or shows love to ourselves. It can mean mindful meditation for some, journaling or coloring for others, or even preparing and enjoying a healthy meal. This way, you can give back to yourself. Do whatever you define as self-care and let your mind heal while the world is trying to do the same. 7. Limit exposure to news and virus updates. Have you been consuming news more than you usually do out of concern? People are panic scrolling for hours and it's becoming a problem. It's good to want to stay informed about the global situation as it helps you feel in control and secure. But politicians, medical professionals, and experts, and people on the internet don't have all the answers you want them to have right now. So try putting your phone away, stepping away from your laptop, and distracting yourself in a healthier way. And 8, focus on what you can control. The uncertainty that comes with the pandemic is difficult indeed, but we know we can control our own actions And we know staying home and practicing social distancing is our best chance at stopping the spread of the virus. Being patient with yourself is also something important you can control. For example, if you're struggling with working or studying from home, remind yourself that it's an adjustment and that sometimes just getting through the day is an accomplishment. You can control what movies or shows you watch and choose to watch more positive and uplifting things. You can control how grateful you are and choose to count the blessings you still have in your life. Remembering the little things you can still do for yourself gives you confidence that you'll be able to survive the challenges you're facing right now. Did these points help you understand what you're feeling right now and why? Was it helpful in pointing out ways to change your routine in a useful way? Do let us know in the comments below. Also, share with those you think might benefit from it as well. Stay safe and stay tuned.